Hello, this is Simone, and welcome to A Road Retraveled. The St. Francis Festival is in full bloom with a flag procession winding through Assisi's beautiful narrow medieval streets. This is a national celebration, being that St. Francis is the patron saint of Italy, and representatives from communities all over Italy take part in the parade, each with a flag bearing their town's name and symbols. Each year, one region has the honor of delivering the blessed olive oil and branches. This year, it was the region of Puglia, on the southern eastern part of Italy. The parade ends at the St. Francis Basilica Piazza, where a sea of people are gathered. Pilgrims, tourists, locals, visitors, and along with camera crews from various Italian TV stations, they listen to speeches made by top government and religious officials honoring St. Francis on his feast day. At least, I guess that's who they are, given I don't know enough Italian to understand what they're talking about. But when I asked others, their answers were pretty vague, and so I sensed that being there was far more important than knowing what's going on. And this is pretty much when I get bored and I leave. But as I was leaving, I ran into a police officer who I met the evening before at the Santa Maria degli Angeli Transit Mass when I was looking for the bus stop back to Assisi. That story was covered in the last episode on the miracle of Santa Maria degli Angeli. The officer that I met came from Puglia on police enforcement duties. But sensing that his services wouldn't be missed for a few minutes during the lengthy speeches, he invited me for a quick coffee.
Noi generalmente facciamo così quando con gli amici, non solo con dalle nostre parti è normale comportarsi così.
Then for lunch, we'll have a picnic with the view up above Assisi at Rocca Maggiore. But first, we have to shop for picnic food, starting off at my favorite little negozio or grocery shop on Via San Francesco that sells a little bit of everything. The unusual thing about this grocery store is it doesn't have a sign. And I didn't know its name. All I know, it's owned by two brothers, and they personally tend to each customer like they're a guest in their home. Let's go! We're once again in Piazza del Comune, and one thing that it's a must in Assisi or anywhere in Italy is to have a picnic. And that's really easy to do. You have a lot of negozi, which, you know, little shops, where you can go to get whatever you need. Things for sandwiches, fruits, vegetables, wine. And it's really fun to go from different little stores. You have one store for your meats, macellaria, where you can get salamis or prosciutto. And you can go to the bakery. I think it's called a forno. Or you can buy the bread at the regular little supermarket. There are also produce stores, and you can get your fresh fruits and vegetables and whatever you like, and have a picnic. So that's what we're gonna do right now. We're gonna walk down Via San Francesco, and we're going to go to my favorite little negozio, the little market. Buongiorno. Come questa.
Hai fatto? San Francesco?
Sì. Non ho trovato niente.
Ma quando c'è troppa gente non si riesce né a vedere né a capire, non si... più per televisione, perché in televisione c'era la Rai, c'era la messa, c'era tutta la cerimonia, ma a piedi così è difficile vedere, sì. Molto difficile. Però c'è l'atmosfera, capito? L'atmosfera della festa.
They have a large selection of balsamic vinegar from Modena and also olive oil from Umbria, from Trevi, another nearby town. And they have small bottles too that are great to take with you if you don't want to carry large bottles of olive oil or balsamic vinegar or liqueurs. They have mandarin liqueurs. They have, truffle liqueur. I wonder what it's a grappa. Grappa, it's a clear liqueur that tastes a little bit like moonshine. They also have amaro. Amaro is bitters. You drink that before dinner, and they also have here truffle bitters. I tried it before. It's good, but it's bitter. Un po' di olive.
Nere.
Dove si trova i tartufi? So from what Sandra told me, the truffles come from the mountain and they have special hunting dogs that search for the truffles underneath the ground. They also have special pigs, but the pigs tend to eat the truffles. But the dogs, who also would love to eat the truffles, don't, because they're trained to consider the truffles a prize for their masters. So they find the truffles and then they back off and offer the trophy to the master. And the way to prepare the truffle, each truffle is like about the size of a large raspberry, and that's about one serving. After the truffle is washed and dried, then you grate it and you heat up some olive oil with onion. And then once it's warm, you turn off the fire, and then you add the grated truffle and you mix it in, and then you pour over pasta or bruschetta. Yeah, you don't eat it with meat or anything. And it's about 60 euros for a gram. È delizioso, sì?
Sì, no, va
bene. E formaggio.
Come? Dolce o un po' saporito? Piccanti.
Che credi?
C'è anche il formaggio.
Che va bene con prosciutto e olive?
Beh, forse un po' saporito, sì. Un po' saporito, non dolce.
Ok. Ho dimenticato. Come vi chiama, fratelli?
Frondu, adesso do lo scontrino. C'è scritto.
Ok.
Vuoi altro?
Vabbè,
tanto io faccio.
Oh, fratelli frondutti. Grazie, ciao ciao. A dopo.